again. So today we're going to do the respiratory lab. So these are the structures that you need to know for your lab, and I'll upload the list of structures for you. And I'm going to show you some pictures from diagrams in the book as well as the models. Remember, anything you see in here is fair game, as well as sometimes I find similar images off the internet that look very similar, or some different models in the lab. But just like driving a car, if I put you in a Chevrolet or a Ford or a Toyota, you can figure out the steering wheel, even though they look nothing the same. You know where it is. You can figure out where the accelerator is, the brake. So the human body's the same way. Don't get thrown off by different colors. Know where things should be, and you'll be able to identify the structures on any model that I throw your way. All right, so the respiratory system is going to be made up of the nasal cavity, which is going to be this cavity here. Your nostril is the source for airflow into the nose. You have an oral cavity here, because you can also breathe through your mouth, so I like to include that as well. Your pharynx, which is that space behind the back of your throat. Your larynx, which is where your voice box is. You have your trachea, which is going to bring air into the thoracic cavity. You're going to have a left and a right bronchus. You have two lungs. Each lung is in its own pleural cavity, so make sure you look over those pleural membranes, your visceral pleura and your parietal pleura. So make sure you know which one surrounds the cavity and which one is on top of the organ. So your visceral pleura and your parietal pleura are also fair game. Let's see. Anything that you've learned in the past is always fair game on future units. So that's we're building our information. So then we also have our diaphragm. Whew, it's a long day. So let me go down to this next picture. Remember when we talk about the pharynx, this is going to contain things like the tonsils, the uvula, and the epiglottis. So the pharynx is divided into the nasopharynx, which is behind the nose, the oropharynx, which is what you can see if you look back to the back of your throat, and the laryngeopharynx, which is right above the larynx. But all that makes up the pharynx. This is going to be your uvula. The uvula is the back of the soft palate, the thing that hangs down the back of your throat. These are your tonsils here, here, and here, and we'll identify the different types of tonsils in just a minute. And then this is the epiglottis. Okay. Here is another image of all these things. I've got it labeled for you. I've tried to label the things that you have to know. So again, I've got your nasopharynx, oral pharynx, laryngeopharynx labeled. Got the uvula labeled. I've got your palatine tonsils, pharyngeal tonsils, which are also known as your adenoids, and your lingual tonsils are all done for you. You have your cribriform plate, where your olfactory nerves can come down. You have your nasal conchae, your superior, middle, and inferior nasal conchae, the nasal meatus, which are pathways between the nasal conchae to allow air to go into your nose. The opening to your nose is called the nostril, also known as, your nostrils, where the air comes in. nares, or nares, this is another word for kind of the nose area, the nostril and nasal cavity area. Those nasal conchae, I'm looking at my list so I don't forget anything. The nasal conchae are covered in mucous membranes. All that pink stuff you see is the mucous membranes that cover that. When you're looking into a skeleton, you'll remember that there is the vomer and the ethmoid make a partition between left and right. So there is a nasal septum. I don't really have a good model that has a view of the nasal septum, but you can imagine if you were looking straight on to onto a model, you would see a line and that separates the left and right side of the nasal cavity. That would be your nasal septum. Let's see. I talked about the pharynx. Note that the uvula is part of the nasopharynx, so it's going to be in that area behind your nose, but it's considered part of the nasopharynx, that part that hangs down the back of your throat. Your tonsils, again, those three pharyngeal, palatine, and lingual tonsils are there. If you're coming on down, here's your epiglottis. This is going to be your trachea. So this area here is all included as part of your larynx, which includes the vocal cords, which includes your false and true vocal cords, your vestibular and folds and your vocal folds. So your vestibular folds are kind of the top thing that you see, then your true vocal cords are right here. So we'll blow that up, make it a little bit bigger. Again, you can see the epiglottis here. Here's the vestibular or false vocal cord. Here's the true vocal cord. The two vocal cords, when they come together, there's a space there called the glottis. Here's the trachea here as well. Looking down into the larynx, you can see the true vocal vocal cords. The true vocal folds are these white things. The vestibular folds or the false vocal cords are on either side. When that space opens up, you have the glottis. Okay, so you can see that. Just to remind you that your esophagus is behind the trachea, and your trachea is made up of these cartilaginous rings, and I say rings, but really they're more like cartilaginous horseshoes. At the back of the trachea is actually going to have a muscle called the trachealis muscle and some soft material. So that the esophagus, it does give it room to expand a little bit. So you have the cartilage keeps your trachea open and patent all the time, so it's gonna won't collapse. But if you have a big bolus of food going through the esophagus and trying to go through, it does allow for some stretching anteriorly forward so that things can pass through the esophagus without obstructing the trachea, okay? So you may have felt that sometimes. It almost feels like something's scraping as it goes down. It's a big piece of food. You can actually kind of feel some of that stretching there. If you look at the lumen of the trachea, remember lumen's just the inside of a tube, you will see that there are hairs, little cilia, and this is what's gonna, as you breathe things in, there's a lot of mucus there, it'll catch dust and things like that, and the cilia will constantly sweep that stuff up the trachea, and then you'll just swallow it down your esophagus and get rid of it. You'll see that these cartilaginous rings are made of hyaline cartilage, not elastic cartilage, not fibrocartilage, but hyaline cartilage. Between the cartilage and the lumen, you have a mucosal layer. So this mucosal layer makes mucus, which catches the dust, which the cilia then brush up. So there's histology, just to remind you that this is what the hyaline cartilage looks like. It's that plasticky glass looking stuff. So this is the matrix of the hyaline cartilage. And remember, chondrocytes make cartilage, and so they live in little houses called lacuna. So each little circle is a lacuna, and inside each lacuna is a chondrocyte, and that's the nucleus of the chondrocyte. So these are what are making the hyaline cartilage. Here is your submucosal layer. So these are the cells that make the mucus. Superficial to that, you have a connective tissue layer. And then just superficial to that, toward the lumen, is your mucosal layer. So this is submucosa. This is your mucosal layer here. And you can see this is pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium. So it's that fake layered. So you can see the nuclei don't line up, but it's only one cell thick, and they're columnar, and they have cilia on them. So pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium are going to be making up the mucosa of the trachea. So this is all fair game for the histology. All right, another picture to show the trachea. The trachea is going to come down and divide into a left and right primary bronchus. So you have a left and right bronchus. These will then divide again. We call that a secondary bronchus, and then those divide again and become a tertiary bronchus. They continue to divide and divide and divide, but the only ones you have to do are go primary, secondary, tertiary. That's all you have to know. The right side of the lung has a superior, middle, and inferior lobe. The left side has a superior and inferior lobe. The alveoli are going to be those small sacs, these small bag areas that are all joined together to make an alveolar sac. So this this kind of bundle of grapes, the individual grapes are called the alveoli. The whole bundle is called the alveolar sac. Air gets to the alveolar sac through the alveolar duct, which comes off the respiratory bronchial, which comes off the terminal bronchial. Remember, if you look at this, this is the alveolar sac. You can see each alveoli, they're all connected. There's pores between each sac, so air can move in between. You have gas exchange, we have capillary beds. So this is going to be the arterial side. Remember, it's blue, deoxygenated, going to pick up oxygen. This is going to be the venous side, picking up the oxygen, taking it back to the heart. All right, so some model pictures. Okay, so here is coming into the nose. You have your nasal cavity here. You have your three nasal conchae, superior, middle, and inferior, with the meatus in between. Here's a pharyngeal tonsil here. I can kind of make out a palatine tonsil here. I have a better picture on another model. Here's your uvula. Here's your epiglottis. This whole thing is your larynx. All this is your larynx. You can see this is going to be where your vocal cords are. I've got a better picture of that as well. This is esophagus, and this is trachea. Okay, let's go to another one. This is a little better. Let me change colors. Maybe that'll help. Okay, so again, here's your nostrils. You can see the little hole there. Again, you have your, that's not showing up either. They're dark. Your nasal conchae with your meatus in between. You have your adenoids or your pharyngeal tonsils. You have your palatine tonsils here and your lingual tonsils here. And again, you have your uvula. You have your true vocal cords on the bottom. Your false vocal cords are that kind of fold that you can see on the top. Epiglottis here, trachea, and of course esophagus is that thin tube on the back side. Let's see. So all of this, when you're talking about really above the vocal cord, so kind of above the glottis, so everything that's kind of above this line, we call that the upper respiratory tract. So if you get an upper respiratory tract, it's really in something in your nose, in your sinuses, in your throat. That's all upper respiratory. Once you get below this line and you enter into the trachea, so below the glottis, so let's just say the glottis is kind of the line. Anything above the glottis is upper respiratory. Anything below is lower respiratory, which includes the trachea and down into the lungs. So let's draw that line again. So we'll draw it right here. So we have our true vocal cords, our false vocal cords, and now we're in the lower respiratory. This is upper. Here we have our nostril, our conchae again, tonsils, uvula, there's tonsils, epiglottis, all these little things are sinuses. This is your esophagus here. It's a blown up picture of the larynx. This is your hyoid bone. Okay, so this is your thyroid. This is your trachea. All right, so open that up. Again, you can see the epiglottis. Here is your false vocal cord, your true vocal cord. And going down into the trachea again. If you look at the torso model and get your bearings, this is the left side. It's got one, two lobes. You have the cardiac notch here. Your right has your superior, middle, and inferior lobes here. This is your diaphragm going across below the lungs, which separates your thoracic cavity from your abdominal cavity. Here we've taken away, kind of cut into the lungs. So you can see here's your trachea, your left and right primary bronchus. That's going to divide into a secondary bronchus and then on out to your tertiary bronchus here. This is your esophagus behind, and here is your aorta. So here's your trachea, and then behind that's your esophagus and your aorta. You have your pulmonary arteries and veins. So this is a pulmonary artery because it's blue. These are pulmonary veins bringing oxygenated blood back. And then as you go out, these smaller and smaller will be your pulmonary arterioles and smaller pulmonary arteries and smaller pulmonary veins that go into pulmonary arterioles and pulmonary venules. But basically, I'll ask you pulmonary arteries and pulmonary veins. Remember, there's two pulmonary arteries, a left and a right. There's four pulmonary veins. Two go to the left side, or come from the left side, and two come from the right side. Just another version, trachea with bronchus and aorta and esophagus. Again, pulmonary arteries and pulmonary veins on the left side. Right side. So on your right side. What else? Oh, diaphragm. This whole thing's a diaphragm down here. Here's another diaphragm. Left side, right side. So again, trachea, primary bronchus, splitting into secondary, and then splitting down into tertiary there. Again, you can see pulmonary veins, pulmonary arteries, esophagus, and aorta. Right side has 1, 2, 3 lobes, and left side has 1, 2 lobes with the cardiac notch. All right, just one more picture, kind of showing the whole respiratory system. So you have everything from the nares, the air coming in and going down to the trachea all the way into the lungs. And you can see the left lung and the right lung has been broken away. So you can see primary, secondary, and tertiary bronchi there. You can see a terminal bronchial here going into a respiratory bronchial, into a huge, or actually small, alveolar sac. You can see the individual alveoli here. You can see the pulmonary arterioles that are going to then form these capillaries, and then that's going to pick up the blood in return via the pulmonary venules. Okay, blue is arterial, red is venule. All right, I think I've covered everything. So just again, look at your list of structures, and I think we're good. And that's it. Thanks a lot. There's your lab.